And a good day, my friends. Jewel here with you with the J7409 Weather Channel. Looking at this surface map and what's going on today, my goodness gracious, I wish I could tell you no more severe weather, but folks, we got lots of it. We'll check it out in complete detail, but you know, we got a front extending from parts of the Great Lakes, the Mid-Atlantic to the southeast, and then to the southern plains. Well, it's going to move eastward to the east coast and stall out overnight tonight. And here it is right here. And look at all the rain coming down. My goodness gracious. Rain, rain, more rain. Severe weather, severe weather. Good chance of severe weather up in these areas here in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and going into New York. It's looking like that the boundary will produce showers and thunderstorms with some heavy rain over parts of southeastern New York State, Delaware, and Pennsylvania. Now, what's associated with these storms looking like heavy rain, maybe some localized flash flooding in the urban areas and roads and small streams. That's what it's looking like right now. But then we have an associated front. In other words, what it is, it's right here. It's coming down. We've got an associated front, and that's going to create more showers and thunderstorms over parts of New York, Pennsylvania, Maryland, Delaware, Virginia, and North Carolina. Risks with these storms are going to last through Wednesday morning, and the hazards with these storms look like a lot of frequent lightning. Boy, I had some last night. Severe thunderstorm, wind gust, hail, and a chance of tornadoes. So be aware, folks, we got all this stuff going on, and it's not going to stop for a while. It's like you have to watch your skies every single day. Now, with this front that I just talked about, this one, well, I didn't just talk about it, but this one coming in right here, my goodness gracious, folks, it's looking like showers, severe thunderstorms. They are going to develop over parts of southern Kansas, Oklahoma, extreme southwestern Missouri, and northwestern Arkansas. Hazards associated with these storms are frequent lightning, severe thunderstorm, wind gusts, hail, and tornadoes. And that's going to go on later this afternoon, tonight, through Wednesday morning also. Now, it doesn't stop there. Upper level energy and a nearby front is going to produce showers and severe thunderstorms over South Dakota and Nebraska, as you can see right here. Now, it's looking like they're going to last through Wednesday morning, and the hazards with these storms, hail, high damaging winds, lightning, and tornadoes. It's all there, folks. It's all there. And some of these storms are going to move across. They might be a little slower moving. They might even last maybe till the early morning hours of Thursday. Okay? Now, it's looking like upper-level energy as it moves eastward over the upper Midwest. We've got all of this stuff going on right here. As you can see, this is all, look at all these lows, upper-level energy all in this area. And that's going to bring severe thunderstorms over parts in these areas here. Same deal. Bad thunderstorms, lightning, thunder, bad wind, hail, and tornadoes. Now, what's going on out in Northern California or out west? Well, it looks like, you see this right here? See this low right in here? Well, that's an upper level impulse, and it's going to develop, okay? And it will be developing an upper-level trough. And what that's going to do is it's going to trigger some scattered showers and thunderstorms over parts of the Great Basin, Pacific Northwest, Northern California, and the Northern Rockies today. And that's going to continue to move right on through Thursday. And we still got some wildfire smoke from Canada, and that's going to reduce the air quality over parts of the upper Mississippi Valley and Great Lakes, and that's going to prompt air quality warnings over that area. And the smoke could reduce the air quality even a little further south into the Ohio Valley. And this heat is not going to stop, folks. An upper level high over the south central portion of the country, along with the high temperatures and temperatures not cooling off much at night, all contribute to excessive heat warnings and heat advisories over most of Texas, southwest, southern New Mexico, southeastern Oklahoma, southern Arkansas, Louisiana, southern Mississippi, southwestern Alabama, and the Florida Panhandle, where you guys are going to be, oh, in the triple digits and almost 100 over here in Florida. Look at this, 97 for today's high. Louisiana, upper 90s. Who knows, you might get close to 100. Texas, you are in the triple digits. Oklahoma, triple digits. Parts of New Mexico, triple digits. Look over here in Arizona. Parts of Arizona, 108 degrees today is in the forecast. Now, over here on the eastern seaboard, when you get to New Jersey, looking like it shouldn't be quite as hot, you should be in the upper 70s, maybe the lower 80s. Same thing going on for Massachusetts. Same thing going on for Long Island and New York, all these areas here. Kind of warm. Northern California, 99. Look at that. Portions of Oregon, 84. Washington State, 82. Over in Maine, you're going to be in the upper 60s. It's going to be pleasant for you guys right up in there. Everybody, we have to look out for severe weather just about every day this week. And where is it looking like today? Well, as you can see, these are going to be storms, folks, that produce very severe winds, possibly in excess of 75 miles per hour. That's Category 1 hurricane winds. This has been going on for days. Don't take it lightly. In excess of 75 mile per hour winds are most probable in a little corridor just southwest of Kansas to the Oklahoma Panhandle, then potentially into the Ozark Plateau. Now, sporadic severe hail will be possible over parts of the northern plains with some damaging winds over parts of the mid-Atlantic. Now, when I was talking about hail, I meant it. But first, let's see what the tornado outlook is looking like. You can see it's in the entire northern section of Oklahoma, including most of the panhandle, moving over a little bit into southeastern Colorado and all around Kansas, including Liberia, Woodward, Garden City, up north in Nebraska. You can see this is Valentine right up in here, getting close to Rapid City in South Dakota. Don't flip your nose up at 2%. We've had them all, and they've killed people this year, and it seems to continue to do so. The wind is going to really pick up. Significant wind from Arkansas moving all the way across to Kansas. Look at this, way, way up there. Now, I'm talking 75 mile per hour or plus winds could be in this area right in here. Wind's going to blow up in Nebraska too, and it's going to be rather gusty all the way from New York going down to not quite Wilmington. I'd say maybe around Jacksonville, North Carolina. Everybody, it's going to be gusty, gusty winds coming up. Now, so far as the hail goes, so far as the hail. Look, I've already seen some places. It's just refreshing, folks. That's all it's doing. I've seen some places. 2-inch hail's a very good possibility with these storms over here in the Oklahoma Panhandle and in Kansas, maybe down in southeastern Colorado, right in here. You guys are going to have this big, big hail chance today. And the hail's another thing. Folks, the hail seems like it wants to increase all the time these days. And instead of getting down to penny and nickel size, we're having like ping pong ball size and greater. Just a few days ago, over, bigger than a softball. Can you believe that? Well, it happened. And a significant chance of some of that big hail is going to be happening up in Nebraska and down in South Dakota also. So that's what it's looking like, folks. Stay safe, for goodness sakes. Just watch your skies. If anything pops up, make sure you got a safe place that you can get to fairly quickly. If you're on the road, stop, go in a store, go somewhere to stay safe, okay? Because these storms are very unpredictable at this time. They're doing very, very strange things with very high winds. You may get rain. You may not. You may get wind. You may not get rain. You may get tornadoes with a mixture of everything. So, you know, I'm not blowing this out of proportion. I'm just telling you, you need to watch your skies if you are in any of these areas and stay safe. Hey, have yourself a good day. Best kind of day you can have. Don't forget, do unto others as you'd have them do unto you. Okay? I love you guys. Thanks for everything you do for me. And may each of you have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day with much peace, love, and kindness. Thanks for watching.